I've told you before, my father was infantry in World War II, about as patriotic as you can possibly get. And if you ever read Tom Brokaw's book on The Greatest Generation, it described my father. That's the way he was. And I remember, I've told this story before, but I remember standing in line holding his hand as an elementary student to chew up a sugar cube with a polio vaccine. And my father would have never questioned the science or the government or anybody else that was promoting the polio vaccine. And we've seen what the polio vaccine has done in our community. It's prevented the disease. We rarely, in fact, I don't know of any cases in the United States of polio in many, many years. We crushed the disease by crushing the sugar cube. That's the way my father, it was, for him, it was not only, it was a civic responsibility. It was to protect me, but with these vaccines, has been highlighted multiple times, getting the vaccine is your civic responsibility to protect the people around you. Because if you're not spreading the virus, other people don't get infected. It's important for you with your children. This is a virus. It's not a political issue. It doesn't, you know, follow state lines, political divisions, or anything else. It's just a virus. And it's mutated. And it may mutate more if we don't get it stopped. Hospitals and our healthcare providers are doing everything they possibly can to take care of our patients. But Dr. Watson made the point that there are so many people who get sick with COVID, end up in the hospital and say, either I wish I'd taken the vaccine or can you give it to me now? It's too late. By getting vaccinated today, you can have full protection. You know, it takes about 5 weeks to get full protection if you take one of the Pfizer vaccines. It's not too late. You can help us get this outbreak under control. I appreciate all of you being here today. I appreciate all of my colleagues for the very, very important messages. And I want to highlight one thing again that Kersey and Dr. Watson made the point about. Kudos to our nurses and our allied professionals. They are the real heroes here. We couldn't do any of this without our nursing staff across the entire state. They don't get enough recognition. Thank you.